Hi. Wow. Starting to get chilly. Aren't you chilly? No. Probably not. All your muscles just keeping you warm. They're nice. I'm happy to see you. And I wanted to tell you that you're doing a really good job guarding the back of the bank. And I will say that I was doing a really good job watching you guard the back of the bank from my window here at the esteemed Greystone Park Psychiatric Hospital. You know, I'm not supposed to be out here right now. It's nap time. Can you believe they added a new nap time on the schedule? They call it new nap Jello 35. It's 35 more minutes of napping, or if you're not tired, then 35 more minutes of eating Jello. A lot of Jello and napping. I guess people are really tired in here. I mean, I don't remember people being so tired the last time I was here. I mean, I guess mental hospitals can do that to you. Either way, we are not allowed out now. So I got Sylvia to come for me. She's up in my room. You see her? She's pretending to be me until new nap Jello 35 is over. Her head is bigger than mine, but they won't know. So cliche. Jello in the mental ward. You know, I heard that they serve chocolate almond milk pudding over at the Trenton Psych over there. I don't know why we can't get some of that in here. We're just as crazy as they are. Oh, wait. They did set the nurse's station on fire last week. Maybe they are crazier than us. Can you imagine? Sounds like so much fun. I mean, not really. I mean, I'm not like a pyro or anything. It's more my mom's deal. But I'm just saying, it would be fun to light something on fire. But then something stupid that nobody wanted, like the nurse's station. You know, I'm totally kidding. Maybe the almond milk calms them down. Maybe they need more naps. Oh, or gum. Great non-medicinal stress reliever. Yeah. Did you know, wait for it, that chewing gum, it reduces cortisol during acute psychological laboratory stress, and that the U.S. Army has long recognized that gum chewing reduces stress, and so chewing gum has been included in combat rations since World War I. Wow. I mean, if it can help in a world war, like especially the first one, when we were still learning how to be at war. I mean, of course it can help us all right now. Gum, it brings people together. Perfect strangers, even. Hi, may I offer you a piece of gum? Why, yes. Thank you very much. And there you have it. Just two people who would never know each other are suddenly sharing a flavor experience, and then maybe even a deeper experience, and then think about the person you may offer a minty piece of gum to. That person could be on their way to their very first date, right? And then they show up with super fresh breath, nothing but net. Game changer. And you and me, we could actually be on the same planet together because our parents shared some gum. I mean, it's so crazy. I like thinking about things like that. Positive outcomes. That's what the guy on the karate video talks about. So, man, chew a piece of gum, get some positive outcomes. What you say, man? Do you wanna say hello? to my little guy.
No.
It might make your face feel better.
Ma'am, I need you to step back. You are over the line.
No, no, I'm not over the line. Here's my line. Look. So I'm in the hospital, out of the hospital. In the hospital, out of the hospital.
Ma'am, stop that.
Oh, okay. You know, you don't have to keep calling me ma'am. I know you're probably not supposed to talk to me, but no one should be called ma'am when it is this pretty outside. I mean, watching the sunset. Oh, hey, that reminds me. I saw a documentary on hamsters yesterday, and it was really good and informative. And you may know these things, but I learned that one, hamsters have feelings, and then, and two, they squeal or scream under stress, and three, they love affection, and it takes them some time to recognize their owners, which is interesting. That sounds like some people we know. And four, hamsters are crepuscular, which means they come out at twilight to eat. Isn't that neat? And look what time it is. Hamsters in our hemisphere right now are going out to eat. I think that's the most wonderful thought. Don't you? Hey, don't you? Also saw a documentary on possums, but it wasn't as good. You know, I can only stay out here a couple of minutes. Do you even want to know what Sylvia demanded to cover for me? My One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest video. My one bootleg VHS copy, which the Greystone Psychiatric Hospital forbids us to watch. So I'm like, Sylvia, I have like 10 karate videos and all of the diehards on DVD. But she's like, if you want me to cover for you while you go out there and talk to that guy who you act like is your boyfriend, even though he's not, fuck your karate videos and your diehard DVDs. I'm watching your illegal VHS Cuckoo's Nest. Or guess what, Wanda, Willie, Ruth, you're not going out. You believe that? But I looked out my window and I saw you out here and I said, okay, Sylvia, here's my cuckoo's nest. You know, you have no idea what you're in for, and don't ask me to explain the themes or the social commentary or what the relationship of the opening and closing shots mean in relation to R.P. McMurphy and Chief Bromden or anything else in Cuckoo's Nest. You're on your own, Sylvia. And for your information, I have smuggled that Cuckoo's Nest VHS, that video home system tape of the best film ever, into every psychiatric hospital I've been admitted to for the past 20 years. And if it snaps, I snap. So you know what that means? It's precious and fragile like the human heart, Sylvia. So when you are done, you better put it back in the plastic case, place it on my shelf upright. And hear this, Sylvia. I'm Wanda Willie Ruth, returning resident of Greystone Park Psychiatric Hospital. So you better be kind and rewind, or I will make you sorry. That's what I said to her. It's like 15 minutes ago, and here I am. It's worth it. I mean, when you're in love with someone, and I'm really in love with them, you can't help but want to stand next to them at any cost. I love you. Did you hear me? Maybe you didn't. I love you.
I heard you, ma'am. I heard you.
Well, do you have anything to say about it?
No, ma'am.
Stop calling me ma'am.
I need you to step back.
I am back.
Behind the line, ma'am.
I am behind the line, and I know as long as I stay behind it, I'm a ward of the hospital, and you're not the boss of me.
No, I'm not, ma'am.
Please stop calling me that. And just tell me what you thought about what I just said. Can you just do that?
No, ma'am. I cannot.
Why?
Because we broke up, Wanda. All right? We already broke up.
No, I didn't. You did.
Why are you making this so hard on me, all right? We agreed you wouldn't come out here. Now you're out here.
I just needed to...
Stop. Okay? We had a good couple months. Now it's over, all right? And you got to cut me a break here.
Anthony, but I...
No. I need it, Wanda. Jesus Christ. Do you think this is easy for me here, having to work here under your window with you staring down at me?
I am not up there staring down on you. Just because I'm institutionalized doesn't mean I'm not busy.
Okay.
There's a lot to do in here.
Yeah.
Greystone okay. Park Psychiatric Hospital is like the carnival cruises of institutions when it comes to activities and duties and other various aspects of being committed that require my attention. I mean, especially for returning patients, because we know where everything is, and they just pound.
I get the point.
Okay, well, just because I happen to look out my window.
No. You don't have to look out your window. You can look out any window in that whole place, okay? But me, I gotta stand right here because this is where I work.
Well, hey, I work too. I mean, it takes a lot of work to keep myself in line, okay? A lot. We both work here. It's not easy for me either.
Okay, shh. Just put it down.
Sorry about your face. Even though I didn't do it directly, I'm sorry.
Look, Wanda.
Oh, how's Anthony Jr.? I thought about him during the Hampshire documentary.
Please do not change the subject, okay? Now, you just told me something, right, a minute ago, and you can't do that.
What? Tell you I love you?
Jesus, Wanda, what did I just tell you? You can't say that.
Why?
Because, you know, I can't say it back.
I didn't ask you to say it back. I just asked if you had anything to say about it.
Wait a minute. Why would you come here and say what you said if you didn't want me to say it back?
I just needed for you.
Because I'm going to let you know, I'm not saying it, okay? I'm not saying it.
But no one's asking you to, not unless you feel like it.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, that's a relief. God, you have no idea how relieving this is because... I mean, let's face it, I mean, you got some major problems here and got issues that I was not prepared to deal with because I'm not really good with issues, okay?
You met me in a psychiatric hospital. Our first date was the day I was released.
Yeah, but you're supposed to be better now.
You're an idiot.
I mean, aren't people supposed to get better?
Well, some people don't right away.
Well, I just didn't know you were going to come right back here.
Well, I didn't either. Relapses happened, Anthony. It wasn't that bad.
You tore all your clothes off and ran naked through Best Buy.
I know.
Okay? You were hurtling the home theater aisles. Like, I mean, come on, Wanda.
You fainted.
Well, we're not talking about me right now.
Well, we should. You fainted face first into the ink toners.
Okay, you know what? You better get back inside now.
And you fainted on our second date. And you fainted the first time you kissed me. Now, who sounds like they got issues?
Okay, I need you to drop this now. Please.
You can tell me. It's nothing to be embarrassed about. The possums faint all the time. I learned that on the other documentary. There's no such thing as playing possum because they have this condition. And it's called cardiac psychopus possum disorder or something like that. And it causes their poor little hearts to just short circuit and then they just flip and faint. These poor little things, they must be so emotional.
Yeah, they must be.
Well, I'm sure whatever you have, it's minor. It's just a simple thing.
Just, Wanda, you don't have to say anymore, okay? Just enough.
I'm just saying, maybe you ought to just get checked out to make sure you don't have anything serious or catch anything, you know, from Anthony Jr.
Shut up.
Now that could be deadly.
Listen, okay, all right. I'm telling you, cut it out, all right. I can't catch anything for Anthony Jr. And you know what? My hamster is as healthy as a horse. Okay, so this isn't funny.
Well, then maybe you do have that cardiac possum disorder. Big strong guy like you. I mean, you don't even need a jacket. That's how strong you are. But could you even imagine that you have this little teeny possum sized heart and then it just shorts out when you get all when you
know, you what get I, No, go ahead, finish, Wanda. When I get what? Finish what were you saying? I got this little possum-sized heart that, you know, shorts out when I get.
When you get scared seeing your girlfriend tear her clothes off and run naked through Best Buy.
Or well, how about this? How about when you get scared knowing how much someone means to you and you want to be good for them? Or like when you asked out Phyllis Flavio Valentine the first week in sixth grade, or when I went skinny dipping with Shirley Finkelstein, that was freshman year. Or how about top it off when I just watched you, you know, run naked
through Best Buy.
Wow. You scared me. You really scared me.
I know. I'm really sorry.
Yeah, it's okay. You didn't know. I'm caring, sharing, right?
Wow.
You know, I actually did finally find out a few years ago, you know, what this thing is. And that was after I fell for this lady mechanic out in Fairlawn. And then I crashed through the guardrails of the Jersey Turnpike. So I went to the doctor, and he says it's rare, but that possum heart thing, it can get passed down. Thank you very much, Dad. And then what happened? So I had to stop being a cop, and I took this bullshit security job at the back of this Morris Plain City Bank here. And you know, I was all right. I thought I had this licked, and I worked really hard not to give a shit about anything. And then I just kind of looked up, and I saw you. You know, in your window, the Greystone Park Psychiatric Hospital.
Anthony.
And then, I went home that night, and then I said to Anthony Jr., I said, Jesus, you got to see this girl up in the window. I mean, she is so terrible looking.
What?
No. I don't mean terrible, like, ugly. I mean more like, kind of like, dangerous. Yeah, because... I mean, someone like you could really do some damage to someone because, you know, you're very beautiful. And then I went back. I told him, I said, you know, I'm going to meet this girl.
You told Anthony Jr. about me?
Yeah.
And what did he say?
Well, not much. I mean, he's a fucking hamster. But, he sees some things. And I'm sure he's had his heart out on the line once or twice. But, I told him about the time you got out, you know, which was our kind of official first date, and how you were walking down the steps and with your suitcase, and you were smiling at me, you know, like you just got out of prison. And I kind of felt in a way like we sort of both just got out of prison, you know, and like I said, I thought I had it licked. And
you do have it licked.
No, I don't. But it's okay. I mean, it's going to be completely okay because I do not love you, Wanda.
Yeah, you do.
No, I don't.
Love me. Yes, you do. I can see it. You totally love me.
I love you, Wanda. I just said that.
You love me, Anthony. It's okay. Admit it. I'm admitting it. I love you. And I know your heart will survive if you say it to me. I'll make it survive. And it doesn't have to be the move the earth or chew your leg off kind of love yet. I mean, that's a tall order for a beginner's possum heart. But admit, you might someday.
I'll tell you what I'm going to admit. What I need to admit is that I can't talk to you anymore. You need to go back inside, all right? And I don't love you. That's it.
Please. I told you what my VHS cuckoo's nest tape means to me, and I just handed it over to Sylvia to come out here and see you, because this is what I know. Positive outcomes, damn it.
I know. I'm sorry. I am. I'm very sorry.
Okay. Okay, fine. Fine. I will stay broken up. I don't have to be your girlfriend anymore. It's fine. Fine by me. You just have a nice swim in your manly sea of denial, and I hope you don't get hurt or killed out here, because then the news will say Anthony Alessandro Badavici killed guarding the back of the bank, survived by his hamster, Anthony Jr., unmarried, didn't even have a girlfriend, but he could have. That's what the news is going to say. Don't worry. I'll go to a new window.
Good. You need to do that. Yes, yes, yes. Oh, okay, yes?
Yes, what?
Yes, okay, to everything we're talking about. Yes.
Yes?
Yes.
So does that mean?
Yeah, yes, you? Yes, yes. Whatever you said I was doing, I guess I'm doing it right now. And
yeah?
Yes, yes.
Really?
Yes, I think so. I just can't say it. I'm telling you, I can't say it, all right? Listen to me. Never been able to say it without smashing into the ground, or without the ground, you know, rushing up, and God, what happens is like...
What's happening?
Hold on a second. Hold on, oh my. Just sit back for a second.
Okay.
No, I'm all right.
Wait, you're not gonna faint.
No, I'm good. Step back, please. Chili pickles, eat them all over again.
I'm back. Here. Just chew some gum. Chew some gum.
I want to go.
Just try it. Please?
Step back, please.
Okay. Is this far enough?
Yeah. No, yeah. Okay. All right, okay. Oh, fuck. All right, let me be all right. Fuck, I'm sweating. God damn it. You see what you do to me?
Anthony, listen. We can get you some real help. We work this out. And once again, behold, the esteemed Greystone Park Psychiatric Hospital. You know, Wanda. They know me here. And they can help.
Wanda?
Do you know how many millions and millions of milligrams of help there is right behind me?
Wanda? This is not going to work.
Well, how about this? Let's just take this really, really, really slow. I mean, think about it. I'm living here for the next month, and you work here at the back of the bank, practically under my window. So I think we're going to kind of be stuck with each other, whether we like it or not.
No, I'm going to ask for a transfer.
What? Where?
To the front of the bank.
No. But I can't see you at the front of the bank.
I'm sorry, but damn it, I want to be able to tell you so bad. I fucking hate this, man. I'm so fucking damn weak. But I can't because I got this weak heart. It cost me everything, and it's killing me. So here's the situation. If I can't be a cop, and I clearly can't be the man that I want to be for you, well, at least I can guard the front of the goddamn bank. That's something, right?
Any idiot can guard the front of the bank, but it takes a really strong person to guard the back. Don't you get it, Anthony? In the back, you don't see it coming, and in the back, anything can happen. I am coming up there, Sylvia. Cuckoo's nest, up, right, and rewound. Or just get your affairs in order. You don't know what you're missing.
No, I can't. No, wait. Hold on. But just come back for a second. Just give me a second. Gum. Yeah, that gum. You said that chewing gum does something for your cortisol levels. What does it do?
It lowers them.
Is that a good thing?
It worked in the war.
You got another piece?
My last one.
Oh, can I have half? Thank you. Juicy fruit. Wanda, Willie, Ruth.
Yes, Anthony, Alessandro Bonavici.
I, I.
All right. Fantastic. If I could have the cast and the playwright and the director back, that would be wonderful.
What happened at the end?
I think it took a carnival cruise.
Okay.
What end? Everything was perfect. So so we have, today is one play, which is all we need. That was great. Gina.
Thank you, Todd.
That was fantastic. So so we're actually gonna do a Q&A. We have already have a hand up. Great, so I also enabled the chat. So we are going, so if you have a question, you could also do, you could do a chat. And Christine, we're actually gonna start with Christine. Christine Blackburn, go
for it. My question's for Gina. Why did you decide to do like a mental institution? Where did you come up with that idea?
Well, first of all, Cuckoo's Nest has always been a favorite film of mine. And it just, I don't know. I really don't know, Christine. I think people who are at the forefront of dealing with their issues, dealing with what's going on with them in a very real manner, offer a tremendous breadth of storytelling. And so, and I have such feeling and compassion and connection to those folks, because I have a lot of that in my own family. And so I've always felt at home with sort of the institutionalized aspect of us. So it just kind of happened, how these two people came to be together sort of in this back parking lot of a bank and a psychiatric hospital. So
thanks, Christine.
Yeah, great. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hey, Field. Dave, you're up. You just have to, there you go. Okay.
There I am. I have learned one thing at Smartphone Theater. Do not try to figure out a Gena Acosta play ahead of time. You have no clue what the hell is going to happen. So congratulations on that. And your casting is pretty damn good too. I don't know enough about the lady though. I've seen the gentleman.
She is, as we said at the beginning, it's introducing Megan Dolan. She is a longtime dear friend of mine and of the directors. We've known each other for many years, and I'm so happy to work with her. And I just, like I told her, I threw her to the wolves with this. And then with Tom, I'd worked with Tom before, and Tom's been on Smartphone before, but it was an absolute total pleasure working with Megan. So thank you so much, Dave.
Sure.
Thanks, Dave.
Onward and onward.
Indeed. Always. Megan, you want to, you're, I guess, a little new, you want to give a little plug to what else you've got going on and what's going on?
Oh, sure. Well, I will do anything to work with Gena and Greg. I have known Greg since, as my dad says, since Christ was a corporal. Greg was my very first acting teacher at Cal State Long Beach multiple years ago, and we were all in a theater company together. So I will do anything they ask me to do. And and when Gena handed me the script, I was like, oh my gosh. So yeah, I was a member of the Elephant Theater with them, and I've done a couple of solo shows. My most recent, it's called Lemur Mom, because we can't all be tiger moms. That was running when COVID hit and stuff. But Yeah, actually, we're going to put up a link to it at lemurmom.com for a limited time if anybody wants to check it out.
But. Yes, please. Lemur Mom, We Can't All Be Tiger Moms is Megan's one-woman show, and it's just... Yes. It's wonderful. It's absolutely wonderful. It's its own little juggernaut. And so please look it up online, you guys.
We'll also put it up on the Smartphone Theater.
Cool.
So absolutely.
Yes.
We're equal opportunity. Tom and I have known each other for 30 years.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, we went to nursery school together. That's why. But Tom, you want to talk a little bit about your background, where you came from?
From New York, born and raised there. I came out to school, UCLA. At that point, I wanted to be a writer. There's writers all in my family, my uncle, my father, and my brother. Everyone's writers. So I started doing that, but I always wanted to be an actor. I was kind of afraid to do it. And then halfway through college, I started acting. And then I found my passion and my niche. And I've been doing it more than I'd like to admit.
Since nursery school. Yes.
I'd say it's working for you, Tom.
Yeah, so would I.
Material and you and great partner like Megan. I mean, if it could be like this every day, you know.
Agreed.
It's really great.
Wow. You guys were stellar. Stellar.
Yes. I'm going to go to Lisa Robbins. So Lisa, just unmute yourself. Good, you're on.
Hey guys. Another fabulous Gena Acosta play. Loved it, loved all the work. Greg, I loved your direction. I love the simplicity of the background. Gotta love the gimmicks, the passing the gum through, the surprises.
Oh, no, I was just a little side joke about the gum with Gena. Yeah.
I know.
Passing the gum.
The acting was just wonderful. Sadly, it's all too familiar to me as well. The behavior, the running naked through the store. And I particularly love that one line. What was it, a grams of healing in that place? What was
that?
Millions and millions of milligrams of help or whatever.
Oh my God, what a fabulous line. I love the metaphor of the back parking lot, and it's just really great work all the way around. Wait, I've got to ask you, Tom, are you related to Gene Alper? Is that?
I don't think so.
Okay. But anyway, love the ending. I too felt that it was hopeful and funny at the same time. So just wonderful. I loved you guys' vulnerability. Just beautiful work. Thank you.
That's great.
Thank you, Lisa.
Thank you.
Sure.
Okay, I'm going to Kelly and Adam.
Oh, Kelly.
Hey.
Hey. I don't have Adam or Michael with me, but I so enjoyed this and really cool to be surprised by Gena's awesome work and watch Megan and Tom, like your chemistry, you're not even in the same room and you guys were amazing. And there were so many times where I just burst into laughter where my neighbors were probably like, what's going on over there?
Good.
Yeah, I mean, when the Jello 35 and oh my gosh, the Megan, when you whispered, I love you, I burst out laughing so hard. And then kept wondering when Tom's going to talk, ma'am. Because we broke up, Wanda. Like, it just was so funny. And the chewing gum theme was cool because it's like we all just shared this flavor experience. Mm. So.
Kelly, I just want to say thank you. It's probably one of the hardest parts is you don't hear any laughter, so you have no idea if things are working or not. I mean, Gena and Greg were great when they were working with us because they were very generous laughers, but that's so nice to hear, so thank you.
No, I kept laughing, and you guys need me as your laugh track.
Yeah.
Kelly, thank you so much, and we'll keep trying to pull Megan into our little Bunko group.
Oh, yeah.
Please.
Oh, she's part of Bunko.
Yeah, this is the Kelly that you met when we were in.
Oh, I came to Lemur Mom.
Yeah,
oh,
she right. came to Lemur Mom. This
oh,
is.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
That was fun. Anyway, thank you guys. This was tremendous.
Thank you, Kelly.
Kelly, thank you so, thank you, so much.
All right, we're going to go to Elijah.
Elijah.
Is this all Elijah right. Douglas?
It's got to be.
Yes. You just need to unmute yourself.
Well, am I muted?
Elijah.
Cool. Hello, Greg. Hey, Gina.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, Elijah.
Good to hear from you.
Very good. I'm doing very good. Thank you guys for inviting me to this. First off, I want to say this was without a doubt a beautiful piece. I genuinely enjoyed this work. The symbolism behind the juicy fruit and the two people was just brilliant. Honestly, that one got me. That definitely got me. I have to say, just the combination of but first off, the two you guys, Megan and sorry, I've got chat up, so blocking your name. But gotta move it over, Tom. You two are both like really, really work really well together. Honestly, you both had me like just drawn in.
Oh, good.
Your chemistry was very great. I genuinely like. Both of you really just killed this role. And Gina, your writing is just so brilliant, honestly.
Thank you, Elijah. Well, you're going to be on here in the not too distant future. I'm just letting you know. So, I'm so, so glad you were able to see this today. Thank you.
Genuinely my pleasure. I want to do this honestly, but I love this piece. Honestly, you're gonna have to send this to me. I genuinely, yeah.
I'll be happy to. So,
thank you.
But like I said, we're gonna be working together soon, and you're gonna be up here. So just I'm letting Todd, the producer, know that Elijah will get to know each other because I'm gonna bring him into a piece that I'm working on. So
fantastic. Let's do it.
Thank you so much, Elijah, for coming and seeing. It's great.
Thank you, Elijah.
Thank you, guys, honestly.
Look forward to meeting you, Elijah.
I look forward to meeting you too, Todd.
Thanks.
Love you, Greg.
Yes, sir.
So, I just said love you, Greg.
All right, cool. So let's see. I'm just going to read a couple of the chats, and then if anybody has any other questions, Tom is the man. Great job, everybody. Brandon says, great job, everybody. I really enjoyed it. Jonathan Levitt, congratulations. Such wonderful performances and great twists in the middle. Sarah Gerfield, where have you been? Congratulations, all. What a gem of a play. Christine, fabulous acting. David Goodman, Tommy! I'm throwing in the, all right. Deborah says, incredible performances in the play is amazing. And Pamela, our own Pamela,
Pam Roylands?
Pam Roylands. So intriguing. Well played and well written. So professional. What happens next with these two?
Tune in next time.
I know.
There's a question. Did the actors learn all those lines? It was flawless.
Negative. No. I would have loved to, but
I memorized the first four lines because, you know, 20 minutes to say them. So, but other than that,
I was trying to choose like what to memorize, and I'm like, where do I? Yeah, no.
We have Lisa Richards says, "Wonderful, really, so well done," and he just needs another piece of gum. A hopeful ending, such imagination and love put into this. That's from Lisa. David Goodman says, Tom. And Christine, I was almost just about to, I saw your hand up, Christine. If you just let me know if you want to come back. Mitch Levine says, what a world y'all have created. Wonderful writing, exceptionally fine directing, exceptionally scintillating acting.
Thank you, Mitch.
So let me see. We have, here's Christine again. Okay. Christine, you're up.
So Todd, how do you choose these plays? Because you must have to really put a lot of thought into what is possible in this circumstance.
It's a very good question, I guess. So we have Gena Acosta. And Gena, this is Gena's fifth play, I think.
I think
so. Yeah. So not only is this Gena's fifth play, but she did the first two. So, and not only that, but Gena and I have worked together quite a bit. So keep that in your mind, and I'll go back to this other thing. I get probably, thankfully, 5 to 10 plays a week, which I'm thrilled by. And I read them. I spend a lot of time reading. These are shorts and full lengths, and I spend a lot of time reading. And not all plays will fit this platform. So I get a lot of wonderful pieces. There's a couple rules of thumb. One is no COVID plays. So nothing that deals with the coronavirus, no COVID. Comedies are great. But if suddenly there's one piece that I'm on the edge with, because it is a COVID piece, but it's very funny. So I'm trying to figure it out. But this is not a COVID. This is a piece for artists and for actors and for playwrights and for directors. It's a moment in our lives where we're able to actually step away from what's going on outside of the walls. And it's really my preference, my choice, just to forget about what's going on. So let's go and explore all sorts of things, but let's not go into the COVID world. The other thing is that we're relatively a family show. So some things which are really fun and really brilliant, but they're either so dark or they start to get a little bit too blue that we just can't do them. So, but at the end of the day, I curate everything. So it's a lot of reading. I understand, especially now, the audience. I understand what works on Zoom. There's some things where the audience, with the cast is just way too large, and there's just too many entrances and exits. So when you have a cast that size, it makes it challenging. It makes it really, really challenging. I'm all for challenges, but you know, we have an hour. So let's play with this hour and have a great time. So thanks, Christine. I hope that answers the question. I'm gonna go, we have Lisa Richards. So Lisa, go for it. You just need to unmute yourself.
Gena and Greg, what a team.
Thank you, Lisa. Thank you.
What a team. And Todd, unbelievable what you've done. And the actors were wonderful. And Todd, I just don't know how you do it. I mean.
with your support, actually. Thank you for, you're so amazing.
So Gena, how many plays have you written?
30.
You know, no, not 30. You know, I'm not sure. I mean, I have a handful of short pieces, and then I have maybe 3 full-length pieces. But when in March, when everything got shut down and Todd asked if I had something, because he was on this thing within 48 hours of lockdown to go, hey, I want to put up a new platform. Do you have something? So I honestly don't know, Lisa. I mean, I've just been going back and looking at maybe 10 of my short pieces. And I just wrote this piece.
They're so different. They're so totally different, Gena. I mean, you're on a different planet every week.
Well, I have to say, when I knew I had Megan and Tom for this, and but I'm sure both of them are just like, oh my gosh, don't call me ever. when I know who I'm writing for, and I had the pleasure of working with Tom and reading with him, and we got to really hang out and kind of know each other, even though we've never met. We've never actually been in the same room together. And then I've known Megan for so long, and I love her work, and I'm such a huge fan of Lemur Mom. When I was able to get the two of them, I kind of just took off with this idea. So I kept giving them new scripts every day.
Oh my goodness. So that's a process, huh?
It was a total process, but I wrote this in like 7 days. But knowing who those two people were, just as I just kept picturing them together. And I was like, I'm going to keep throwing a kitchen sink at them. And they kept going with it. And Greg was so fantastic to go, all right, let me take this bird's nest and hand it over to your actors and help make
sense. So thank you, Lisa, so much. It was really kind of an intense 9 days that I just kept writing and writing and writing, and we kept working and talking. So thank you so much, Lisa.
That's really good for us to know. That's really good, because the end product really looked like it had been really been worked on. One more question. Do you like juicy fruit?
I have a soft spot in my heart for juicy fruit, and I definitely have a soft spot for the reference where it comes from. So, and do you, my dear?
Well, I'm not a gum chewer. Nope.
Wow.
I'm not.
Well, neither is Megan. So, and Megan was an absolute total trooper on this one.
Oh, good, Megan. Very good.
Yeah. Fantastic. Thank you, Lisa.
Thank you, Lisa.
Thank you.
And just to add, just to sum up Christine's question, we have a smartphone theater family outside of how we've known each other. So everybody here is the family. Gena was like our first member into the family. And Lisa, of course, and Tom's. And it keeps on growing. And that's the idea. Our audience as well. So I know we have a lot of returning audience, which is part of our family. So that's what this is. This is all just one big community. That's the point, you know. That's the whole point.
And is it, were you guys part of a theater company before the smartphone theater started? No,
we're part of the actor studio. So
okay.
So I'm a directing member and Gina's a playwright there, and so we've been very lucky and blessed to know a lot of actors, a lot of playwrights, and a lot of directors. So when this first started, you know, Gena was my first call. Because I know,
smart call.
Yeah, I know Gena well, and I know her work. And I went, Gena, guess what? So, but we've been really, really blessed and fortunate that that it's caught on, and that everybody within the studio, or many people within the studio, have gone, hey, this is great, great platform. Here's some scripts that I have, or here's what I've got going on, and people have said yes, and you know, it's been fun. It's been really fun.
And Megan, I will tell you that because Megan was one of my first donations for the Sullivan Girl. And so we kind of connected for that. And so when I got to know Todd, Todd was kind of my linchpin of, I need someone who knows how to do everything that I don't know how to do. So Todd stepped in and became, so Todd is now like my main go-to guy, producer on the Sullivan Girl, which we were poised to go and shoot April 1st.
Oh my God.
Everything. Yes. So the fact that I put him through the ringer all through March and February. So when he called me, he goes, do you have a short play? I'm like, dude, I owe you so much time. I better have a short play to give you. That's the least.
Oh, that's great.
How we sort of started to get to know each other. So, but Megan, I always told you, Todd is a terrific guy to know, as well as Tom. But Todd is a terrific guy to know, just with stuff.
We have stuff.
Now you guys are part of the same community. Well,
he's already taught me skills that I value.
Zoom skills. Yeah, Zoom skills. All right, Christine, we've got you again. You've become our favorite. Christine? Or was that an accident that you raised your hand? Christine?
Is it me?
It is you.
I saw I'm not Christine. I'm Christine's sister.
Oh, okay.
I guess she sent me the link, and so you think I'm her.
Oh, got it.
So my question is, Tom, how do you put that much emotion into it? Like you can literally just start to cry. How do you do that?
It's a good question. I literally can't do it on command, although the two times I've worked here, it seems that way. A lot has to
Well, what does that say?
it says that the material, it's really kind of the material is so well written and so rich, and it's both in both pieces were two characters that I was very able to identify with. Mm. So to answer your question, you know, it's a combination of you know, some of my training and
relaxation, and then the rest of it is just sort of, you know, listening and reacting to this person who I'm with, and you know, I'm in this world.
So you don't put other make-believe sad thoughts in your head, or
I'm sorry,
you don't think of sad things that could happen or have happened in your life.
Well, to be
there's
honest
no time
you,
for that.
Well, yeah, I mean, I was actually trying to do some preparation before this thing, and everybody was talking and so forth, and it was, I'll pretty much use anything I can. So, you know, I'll use some sensory stuff. I'll go back and some, yes, I will try, but sometimes it doesn't work. You know, like you go to the well once too many times, and all of a sudden it's not bothering you anymore. So you always have to constantly keep tricking yourself and coming up with new things and new what ifs and as ifs. And
can I weigh in on that, if it's possible, as a director working with these marvelous actors? You know, as a magician never gives away their secrets, I will say this, that these actors live in the moment of what the play is about and what the story is. And that actually informs that great natural and honest emotional reaction. And that's the truth of it. It's living in the moment of the story. And
wow, good job, Tom.
That's what I meant to say. Thank you.
Awesome. That is great. David Goodman, by the way, Tom, David Goodman says he thinks of me. Okay. All right, good. A couple minutes after six. So we've been
at the whistle.
Yeah, exactly. So it's been a great hour. I do want to tell everybody that next week we're going to try our first Saturday. So we're going next week, Saturday at 5, as opposed to Friday.
Oh, nice.
Just one. We're going to see what it looks like, what it feels like, sort of test the waters. So next week, I know we're a Friday at 5 routine, but next week we're going to go Saturday at 5. So it's just a little bit different. And then the week after that, we'll be back at Fridays, but we're just checking it out, checking the waters.
Should someone be poised to be reading Trojan Women at 5 on Friday just to fill the slot?
Hey, like, not a bad idea. Are you
like
volunteering?
A moaning Trojan woman, just moaning, like with the Greek robes and stuff. Just maybe, like, if somebody wants to tune in.
I was hoping for, Trojan Wars with the American girl dolls.
Yeah.
Except, but, you know. Can't have everything.
I think next week, the two of you have Friday at 5, and you can do anything that you want.
Can I thank both Megan and Tom and you, Todd? You guys are the best.
Thank you. You guys are great.
Just a pleasure. So much fun.
Well, right back at you.
Well.
You too, Tom. Tom and I have never met in real life. I cannot wait till I can just give you a big hug.
Amazing to work with, and you know.
Oh, see, so are you.
Your son, well, your
thank you so much, and Todd, once again, hats off. This is your baby.
Yes, thanks, Todd.
It's great fun.
Todd, you're a very calming presence. I appreciate that.
Gina, I just like to say something to Gina. I mean, you know, I had the pleasure of working with her as an actor, and I thought she, well, you know, she's amazing. And then when I heard she's a writer, I'm thinking, okay. And now, and then I'm realizing that's her passion in acting, and it's just amazing. You're such a great artist, and I see the link between your writing and your acting. It's just your humanity and your wonderful spirit. Oh, yeah. It's just a pleasure to work with you, and I love. I was also a little leery about working with a husband, wife, you know, director, writer thing. You know,
so was I, Tom. So was I.
You guys are so amazing, and just the way you work off each other, how you complement each other. So you both have great strengths that balance each other, and it was a real pleasure to work with you. I never
likewise.
Get to work with
Tom. Thank you.
Likewise, thank you so much.
So much.
We'll do it again.
Well, thank you.
All right.
This has been such a joy. So, yeah.
Stay safe, everybody. Stay well.
Be safe. To this cast and the writer and director, I'm going to send you guys a link for a quick wrap up, and we'll do a little toast. So you'll get that within the next 3 or 5 minutes. To everybody else, we'll see you next Saturday.
Yes, sir.
Saturday.
5 o'clock, and have a great week. Have a very safe
you
week.
Too.
And,
you too.
And we'll See you
Thank
soon.
Thank you, everyone, for tuning in and watching and supporting the work, the actors, and just the platform. Thank you so much.
Megan, I'm sending this
Did
to
I get, wait.
Sending this to I'm sending this to Armagnac.
Oh, my just, God. You know.
All right. Everybody, see you later. Goodbye from L.A.
Bye. Thank you.
God bless.